exciting spring concert. Very excited to have you guys here. In front of you, this group is a group of 7th and 8th graders that meet daily, and they practice as a full band. This is their first year as musicians to practice as a complete band every day. So that presents new challenges for them in terms of what do I sound like with the people? Do I really need to play as loud as I'm playing? Do I need to really play as soft as I'm playing? Lots of balance things. So it's been a really good learning for you, year for them. This has also been the first year that we've done a concert and symphonic band, and the majority of the groups in here are in 7th grade, which is to be expected. It's their second year of playing. We have a few kids in here who are also 8th graders, and these 8th graders, they didn't get into symphonic band last year, which is not a big deal, or this year. But for them, they've really grown a lot, and they've kind of become leaders in this group, and so we're really excited to kind of showcase them. And that's what it's all about, is everybody's able to be successful no matter what group they're in and what level they're being challenged at. So, this group, we're going to play our first song. It's called Majestica by Brian Balmages, and we took this to a competition in Branson that I'll talk to you guys about in just a little bit. But we're really excited to open up our concert. Here's Majestica. This is the ASBOA Region 6 Solo Ensemble, and as a side note, some of you guys volunteered your time, your money, you donated things. I just want to say a huge thank you to you guys. You have no idea how much easier that made my job instead of running around like a chicken with my head cut off. It was amazing having so much parental support. So if you helped in any way, we want to congratulate you. Please give them a round of applause for helping out. I want to say we hosted somewhere around 1,000, 1,200 kids that night, and it went so smoothly. I couldn't even believe it. So smoothly that they said, you should do it next year, and so I'm doing it next year. Okay, here we go. So we're going to recognize a few students. At this competition, they play a solo or an ensemble in front of a judge, and that judge gives them a rating of a 1 to a 5. 1 is the best, and 5 is the worst. And so in terms of medals, we don't give everybody a trophy. Only the first division and second division ratings get a medal of some sort. We're going to recognize the students right now. So students, when I call your name, please come up here. And you can stand with us, and we'll take a photo. Parents, you can snap a photo, whatever you want to do. So we're saving a second division rating on his solo, Alberto Parga. Darian Trujillo received a 2 on his duet with a symphonic. Receiving a first division rating are Lenina Bohannon for her solo. Colton Corcoran for his solo. And they get the chance to do multiple events. Colton also received a first division rating in his duet with Max Halsey as well. That's our medal recipients for solo and ensemble. One thing that's nice about this is there are concert band members next year as eighth graders, or some of them moving on to the high school band, they'll actually get to do solo and ensemble again. It's something we do every year, and it's really, really highly encouraged because it's so much fun to learn something new and somebody's trying to get their attention. Look at your dad. He wants to take a picture. Okay, round of applause for these people. Up next, we have a fun little Latin piece that's when translated means the sailor. It is called El Marinero by Mike Hanicle. I don't know if I said that right. Thank you. Okay. Before we go on to our next song, I do want to recognize a few of our supporters here. To all the teachers and staff and administrators that are here from Kirksey, I want to thank you guys so much. Please give them a round of applause. There's a lot of things that happen behind the scenes that these students don't see, and it's teachers and administrators and staff just working together to accomplish our goals. And I can't tell you how many times that they have to bend over backwards just so that we can accomplish our goals and what we need to do as a band. So I'm tremendously grateful for them. I also want to say a huge thank you to our principals in particular for allowing us, as the only middle school band that I know of in the region that does a concert and symphonic band, dividing students up by ability level and things like that. It's a hard thing to do. It's been a challenge for me this year. This is the first year I've ever done it, and it's kind of been a dream of mine for about a decade now of my teaching career. And seeing these kids and knowing that they're where they need to be and they're not falling behind other students because they're being dragged along and they're not ready to accomplish things that maybe some other groups are doing. The other thing that I like about this is that many of them now have auditioned already for concert symphonic band, and a lot of them are going to be in symphonic band next year. And so they're moving up and maybe they're progressing. Some of them are going to be in concert band again next year, which is not a bad thing. They may need another year to grow, another year to really like strive to be a better player. That's fine. It's all about trying to figure out where they need to be and making them the most successful they can possibly be. In terms of challenging, my goal this year is to make them not feel like the stepchild of the group. And I told them this. I told them that it's very difficult because I don't want them to think that just because I have a symphonic band that's supposed to be better than them doesn't mean that I don't care about them. No, my symphonic band probably makes 10 times more mistakes. Sorry if you're a symphonic band member in here. But they probably take 10 times more mistakes than these guys do. And that's okay. It's a journey as an individual and it's a journey as a group. And so we did all the same stuff. We played pep rallies, we played competitions, we went to Branson together, which was, some of you guys would think it's insane to take 180 middle schoolers to Branson, Missouri and play a competition and go to Silver City for 8 hours. It was insane, and I need more sleep. But these guys have been so fantastic, and people would probably call me insane to work with 100 students, middle school students, and give them giant noisemakers and say, all right, let's have class every single day. But these guys are phenomenal, and it's been such a pleasure to work with them, and I really thank them for that and their hard work and their effort. All right, that's enough of me rambling on, sorry. We're going to go on to our next song, which some of you guys will probably recognize. It is the theme from Spider-Man. Thank you. couple other things that I want to say really quick to you guys since I have you. Number one, if you are an eighth grade parent and your student is planning on doing Rogers High School Band next year, we do have a permission slip or like a contract that you need to get, you guys need to fill out. Technically, it's due tomorrow, but we can accept them all this week because I'm not going to be there tomorrow because of I have to go visit fifth graders. So they can turn it in on Thursday. I have those contracts, so if you want to come and see me right after actually, you know what, let's do this. They're right here, so if you need them, I'm going to lay them right here on the... So that way, in case I'm busy and I don't see you, you can grab them. So just grab those, fill it out, and then turn that in. Have your child turn that in later on. Yes? Oh. What is that? The program? Oh, on the back of the program, there is information about the Rogers High School Band and stuff like that. You can find the Band Booster website, too. But if you need the contract, it's right down here in case you guys need it. Secondly, I do want to say a huge thank you to our upper administration. You can see this nice wooden panel wall here and the wooden ceiling. This is called a shell. And for those of you who don't know it, this is a very expensive piece of machinery. And our administration, upper administration, have blessed us with this because it makes our band sound so much more lively. You probably didn't recognize it unless you're like a band person, but last year when we played on a concert or whatever, earlier this year, about half of our band sound would just die on the stage. It just never went anywhere just because of the way it's designed. But this is amazing. So please, giant round of applause for our upper administration. Nice things are unfortunately very expensive, so we're very grateful for that. The last thing I want to say is a huge thank you to you guys as parents. Your support, and I know it requires a lot of time, it requires a lot of money, and it also requires a lot of Tylenol, having to listen to them play their tests and things like that at home. And I'm so grateful for that, and I couldn't thank you guys enough, because without you guys, we wouldn't have a band program, and we are becoming a very successful band program. I thank you guys so much for your support. We are going to close out our concert with the last song that we took to our Branson trip. These guys had a great time riding rides, playing their music, feeling the pollen rain down in their faces, and having to sneeze all day. What a nightmare the pollen was. But other than that, man, that trip was so much fun. And I think they had a really good time. But this is Dark Fortress.